I'm at Target's Minneapolis headquarters, where the company is getting cute, using everything from elves to its classic mascot to pull at your heartstrings.
This is the room where we're evaluating and preparing all the final creative materials. I'm not trying to sell a mobile device in that case, and I'm not trying to sell Elf on the Shelf, but I am trying to help you fall in love with Target.
Target's office is dripping with its logo, but that excitement has to translate into sales, beginning with Black Friday.
It's a very unique night in retail.
You could have called all of last year unique for Target. The retailer had to cut prices to get people back in stores after a massive credit card data breach. But last quarter's results? Impressive. Now it has to keep up the momentum.
You know, you start to see visually what's happening in the brand.
This is Target's social media center. Who doesn't have one these days? The question is it really driving sales, or is it just a fancy customer service center?
Really enables us to respond real time to consumer complaints and to shape the conversation.
How do you determine between which consumer gets the response and which one doesn't? Because you can't respond to everyone, can you?
You know, it's what we try to look for. Are there patterns of questions, and can we answer once that answers many questions?
And that's great. Target is trying to adapt to an increasingly online world. But more than 95% of its sales still come in the physical store. So we took a walk to the floor. The big question is, how do brick-and-mortar retailers get people in the store and spending money?
The physical store is still very important because that's still where most American consumers shop. It has to be inspiring.
As for the front of the store, I'm assuming that this is an important place in the store, right?
It's actually not an important place, and the reason why is because we don't want to create the congestion right when you walk in the door.
How do you make sure that people come and don't leave disappointed because they didn't get the item that they wanted, the deal that they wanted?
Now, it's always a great balance because it is a limited supply, it's one-night deals, but we also want to make sure we have enough inventory to serve as many guests as possible.
Is there any kind of guarantee that if you show up to a Target store, you'll get the deal that you wanted?
The guarantee is come have a great time shopping at Target.
What's that? The guarantee is that you'll have a great
time? Come have a great time shopping at Target.
But on Black Friday, is a good time really enough? Or do people want deals? Only the numbers can answer that. Cristina Alesci, CNN, Minneapolis.